First Things First is sponsored by Gillette, the best a man can get.
Back here, First Things First, we are now joined by Pro Bowl linebacker Bart Scott. Happy holidays. Welcome to the show, Bart.
Oh, man.
Thanks for being with us.
What? You're fast and fresh today, man.
We are fast.
We knew you were coming on, sir.
Fresh is what I
can. You got any presents today?
Nah, not today, but humbug.
All right, no problem.
All right, Bart, let's talk some Cowboys. They were back in Dallas after suffering that shutout loss to the Colts back in Week 15. Dallas was in control of this entire game, and while they didn't play great on offense, Zeke did run for 85 yards on 18 carries. Dak Prescott accounted for 2 touchdowns, 1 through the air, 1 on the ground. The 27-20 win clinched the NFC East for Dallas. Here was Dak Prescott after the game.
We got a lot more work to do. This is just the start. This is the beginning. This is something that we set out and wanted to do way back in the offseason. And this just gives us a chance to go and get the greater goal.
Bart, all week we wondered which Cowboys team we were going to see. The one that got shut out by the Colts or the one that went on that 5-game win streak. Who did you see yesterday?
I saw something in the middle, in between. Look, Tampa can score on anybody. That's a talented outfit over there. You know, but they can't stop the run. I thought they would be able to pound the ball a little better. I don't know how far this team can go. It's got to be about matchups. You know, they're much better at home than they are on the road. I don't know if they can take it on the road. You would expect that defense and run game travels, but I just don't see them as being a favorite in any of these matchups, especially if they go against somebody like the Bears, who's a better version of themselves, a more explosive offense, more dynamic offense. But they always have a chance when you have a run game. They can get turnovers like they got yesterday.
I don't know how, if you're a Cowboys fan, you could watch the game yesterday and have more confidence in your team moving forward. We knew their defense could be really good, and their defense was excellent. Randy Gregory had a strip sack, and then Jalen Smith showed that he is as healthy as he was pre-injury at Notre Dame, made a great play. They set up another touchdown with a mishandled handoff between James Winston and the running back. Randy Gregory scooped that one up, almost scored, set up that drive inside the 4-yard line. But I said I wanted to see at least 2 of these 3 things improved upon. Red zone offense, keeping Dak upright, and explosive plays. They had 1 explosive play the entire game. 31-yard pass to Michael Gallup. They did keep Dak upright against a very poor pass rush, but in the red zone, like, I'm going to give them an incomplete. One time in the red zone, they got held to a field goal. Another time, after a really odd play to Amari Cooper on first, they had 1st and goal from the 3. They end up kicking a field goal. Another time in the red zone, they set up on the 4-yard line because of the Randy Gregory play. And the one time they did score a touchdown, or the other time they scored a touchdown, they were screwed on that play. Dak took an awful sack, and they got a very fortunate face mask penalty that reset it for him. Like, they weren't sharp in the red zone there. So the concerns I had about Dallas going into the game, we're just confirmed in this football game.
A lot of it's going to be based on what Bart says. Their defense is good enough to be able to put them in championship conversation. But ultimately, will they be able to throw the ball? Will they be able to make enough big plays? Will they be able to generate enough offense in the red zone, touchdowns compared to field goals? And will the defense, besides playing good defense, can they give you that extra possession? Can they give you that? Can they score on defense? Because those are game changers. We saw with Baltimore playing against the Chargers, and if Dallas can continue to do that, it's about matchups. It looked potentially they could face Minnesota in a home game, the first game. So then they're able to get through that. Now you're into the divisional round. I mean, they're not afraid of New Orleans. Will that offense with New Orleans defense match up? Because New Orleans could take them out or limit them in their running game. So Dallas, it's about momentum and matchups going forward, and that's what they're going to have to rely on.
That run game and making sure that they limited the possessions of the opposing offense. But the competition is going to get a lot stiffer when they get into the playoffs. And I just don't know if Dak can carry. You know, I know we saw him, you know, have a coming out party with Amari Cooper a couple of weeks ago when he went for over 200 yards against the Philadelphia Eagles. I just don't know if he can sustain that. I don't know if Dak can make enough plays down the field. So it comes back. They got some tremendous decisions to make in the offseason about who they elect to be their core four. Do they pay Amari? What kind of deal is Dak going to make? But he's going to have to make that case through the playoffs. If he wants to get paid, he has to understand he's playing for his contract. He has to show that he can be more than a game manager. I like to still see him use his feet more. You know, right here, this is exactly what you want to see from him. We see Lamar Jackson, we see Russell Wilson, we see these mobile dual threat quarterbacks being more, you know, aggressive, you know, now that it's coming down. There's nothing to save your body for now. You know, it's no tomorrow. The playoffs for them started this week, and it's going to continue. He's going to have to make sure that he puts himself on the line.
Yeah, I think you make a great point there as far as being more aggressive. Say, well, you tell us we don't want the quarterback running. Well, you got to be yourself.
Yeah.
Russell Wilson, when it comes down to it, man, what is he going to do? He's going to make some plays with his feet. Now, Russell could always throw the ball. Lamar Jackson, what are they doing with him in Baltimore? Yeah. Man, they got a game plan so that he can be successful. Dak is not going to be, at this point in his career, he's not going to be 35 times drop him back. But if he can carry the ball 5 to 8 times to help enhance, to keep that backside, that defense. You talked last week, well, how are they going to get better in the red zone? We saw Dak with the quarterback keep, with the quarterback option. They called it down there. That was a designed quarterback run. Helped them this time when they're getting into red zone. I'm with you. I would be more aggressive. Man, your body, man, listen, dedicate that to the game. Don't be trying to save it. And I just believe that that's going to be his style. And that's how Dallas is going to win a lot of football games if they're going to win.
And that's the only way I think you can score points in this league if you don't have a dynamic downfield passing attack, where your rushing attack is not just one great running back, but where you also have to worry about the quarterback getting out on the edge. And he obviously is not the athlete Lamar Jackson is. I don't even think he's the athlete Russell Wilson is. But he had 0 rushes last week and 4 rushes this week. Right there was his only significant run play of the entire game. His 3 other runs yesterday went for -5 yards. So, like, he needs to have that be a bigger part of his game, because they are not going to have a dynamic passing attack, and they are either playing Minnesota or Seattle in the first round. And I'm telling you right now, either one of those teams is going to say, okay, we are going to eliminate Zeke, see if you can beat us.
Yeah.
And even during this stretch where they've played great, aside from that fourth quarter in overtime against Philly, when have they shown the ability to take advantage of a team selling out against the run and make big plays down the field? Chris, you said you want to see 4 of them. We got 1 yesterday. Like that, they threw for 160 yards. They won the Bucs. They beat the Bucs because the Bucs can't stop shooting themselves in the foot, and they're a really poor football team. There's a lot of teams yesterday would have lost to.
We got very excited when we saw that breakout game by Amari Cooper, and it was the culmination of 3 or 4 games getting into the offense, getting comfortable with the offense, and then exploding. What's happened to Amari Cooper? Why hasn't that helped Dak?
Well, the defenses have given him more attention, but Dak, they don't believe a lot in the downfield passing game. So Amari Cooper, for me, never should be targeted 5 times unless it's a hurricane or something. The weather, like, we can't throw the ball. Not targeted enough. And he should be the emphasis of the passing game. But there's a trust factor, and it comes with the Dallas staff. Do they trust Dak to throw the ball down the field? Because Amari, man, he is more of a intermediate and deep threat than he is that short dink and dunk stuff.
And that's, I'm sorry to interrupt, but that, I mean, you just look at who he threw the ball to. Cole Beasley and Zeke were targeted 11 times. Now, they caught 10 of them for a grand total of 74 yards. Like, the Amari and Michael Gallup are going to be the guys who are going to get some type of separation down the field, going to be deep threats. Like, Dak is very, you say there's no, you never go broke taking a profit, but you can go broke just breaking even every year if you lose a little bit. Like, that's what, I mean, every time, oh, I can get a completion here, no problem. Even
if we only use that phrase, you never go broke taking a profit, when you have other decisions.
Right.
All right, their primary decision is to throw it short, so.
Who's going to step up and be their number two? That's the problem, because I thought they, you know, made the move for Allen to come in and be that guy. Mm-hmm. He was supposed to be the lead guy. He's not even on the stat sheet.
No.
You know what I'm saying? That's a problem.
He's been a bust.
Yeah, Michael Gallup's been inconsistent, a young player, but also the throws have been inconsistent. So it's hard to develop continuity in the passing game when the coaching staff doesn't believe a lot in throwing the ball down the field. That part, and Amari Cooper, you just don't see it week in and week out. That's what I would make them force me to throw the ball away from Amari Cooper, because I'm going to force feed him.
They're going to have to be creative. They're going to have to move him around in the slot. You know how it is. Guys are rolling coverage to him. You got to take the target out of his back, put him off where they can't jam him, put him in a slot so that he can do some of those speedos and over routes where you can't really, you know, you really can't double him and take him away.
With all that said, another marvelous performance by the defense. The defense basically outscored Tampa by themselves if the Gregory would have gone for a touchdown. The defense was great and is in playoff form right now.
And they're going to have to be great if this offense has
only
any chance.
Bart,
stick around. Coming up, does Tom Brady look like he's got another Super Bowl run in him? That's next on First Things First.
Brady don't look like he's got another run to the grocery store in him.
Eating them nightshades, I think.